Aspiration pneumonia is a type of pneumonia that occurs when bacteria is aspirated into the lungs. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Pneumonia is an infection that causes inflammation in the lungs and results in fluid buildup, fever, cough, and difficulty breathing. It's caused by a variety of different organisms, including viruses, bacteria, fungi, and even parasites in some cases. When this disease is contracted due to aspirated bacteria, as previously mentioned, it is referred to as aspiration pneumonia. The other types of pneumonia include community-acquired pneumonia, hospital-acquired pneumonia, and ventilator-associated pneumonia. As you may have guessed, the specific type of pneumonia is classified according to how the patient acquires the disease. Community-acquired pneumonia is when a patient is infected outside of the hospital setting. Hospital-acquired pneumonia is when a patient gets it during a hospital stay. And ventilator-associated pneumonia is when it's acquired while the patient is on the mechanical ventilator. But for this video, we're specifically focusing on aspiration pneumonia. As previously mentioned, aspiration pneumonia is acquired when a patient aspirates bacteria into the lungs, usually from food, saliva, or stomach acid. These contents are meant to be swallowed through the esophagus into the stomach. However, when they are instead aspirated through the trachea into the airways of the lungs, this is when the problem begins and an infection can ensue. Aspiration pneumonia can vary from mild to severe, depending on the patient's signs and symptoms. Some examples to look for include a productive cough, fever and chills, tachypnea, shortness of breath, chest pain, diaphoresis, fatigue, and cyanosis. Being able to recognize the signs and symptoms is important for the diagnosis, treatment, and patient outlook. Speaking of treatment, pneumonia in general should be treated on a case-by-case basis. Here are some of the most common treatment methods: antibiotic medications, oxygen therapy, bed rest, airway clearance therapy, hyperinflation therapy, and fluid management. Each patient may require different treatment modalities depending on their signs and symptoms. In severe cases, intubation and mechanical ventilation may be indicated. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. But real quick, if you don't mind, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And you might as well go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. Hopefully what you learned in this video was helpful and can help you develop a better understanding of this topic. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to dive even deeper, we do have a full guide on our website. I'll drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.